Yes, students, today we'll discuss one experiment. This is Stewart G experiment. The main aim of the experiment is studying magnetic field along the axis of the coil. Okay, so see the experiment, see the apparatus, and in the Stewart G apparatus, this is tangent galvanometer. It consists of a coil. Okay. Here in this coil, copper wiring will be there, wandering of copper wire will be there. So how many number of turnings are there according to this given value? Maximum 500 number of turnings are there. So when current passes through the copper wire, that is coil, in the vicinity of coil, in the surroundings of the coil, magnetic field will be produced. So at the center of the coil, from center of the coil to along the axis of the coil in two directions, how it is varying, that we have to measure. To measure it, initially you have to place these arms of the tangent galvanometer in tangy position, that is in east-west direction, magnetic meridian direction. And second thing, you have to set, see, by moving this, you can move deflection magnetometer. So coming to this deflection magnetometer, whenever there is a magnetic field, it will be get deflected. See here, in the deflection magnetometer, one white needle is there, that is called aluminium pointer. Second one, a black strip is there, that is magnet, freely suspended magnet. When you suspend a magnet freely, it aligns in the direction of the earth magnetic field. Okay. And while doing the experiment, you have to make that earth magnetic field zero. To do that, actually, you have to keep at the center of the coil. After that, you rotate this so that the magnetic needle reads 0, 0. See here, at that position some value is there. Now at this position, aluminium pointer showing some another value. Just simply rotate it and make aluminium pointer 0, 0. But here very important thing, without parallax error you have to show. That is, you have to see. See, what you have to do is, you keep your head straight and close one eyes and see such that the mirror image of aluminium pointer and magnetic needle coincide each other, then you rotate. So after that rotation, see that two ends of the needle aligns 0, 0 or reads the 0, 0 reading. Now this is, see, okay. Now it is 0, 0. Clear? So this is the basic setting of apparatus, tangent galvanometer. Now we made earth magnetic field, effect of earth magnetic field 0 over here. That is, deflection due to that is 0. Now when current passes through it, whatever the deflection is there, that we see. Right? Now we'll see the connections. See, in the coming to the case, this is voltage regulator, voltage source, and this is plug key. In plug key, four pins are there. Across two pins, you connect tangent galvanometer setup, and across two pins, another circuit. This is primary circuit, and another one is the secondary circuit. Okay, first we'll connect the tangent galvanometer. Afterwards, we will see the primary circuit. Okay. So, now we will see the connections. This is voltage source and this is commutator. So, from commutator, between two ends, see this one and this one. Between two ends, what we are doing? We are connecting this tangent galvanometer. From one end of commutator to first knob, okay, that is initial point of the coil, and from another opposite end of the commutator, we are giving to required, we are taking required number of rings. Here it is taken 50, 50 rings are taken. So this is end of the 50th ring. Only 50 rings we are considering into the coil. This is primary circuit. Now we'll see secondary circuit. Secondary circuit should be connected across these two opposite ends. Okay. Between two opposite ends, one pair of opposite ends, we have connected tangent galvanometer. remaining across remaining two opposite ends, we have to connect the remaining circuit. We'll see that circuit. See, this is voltage regulator from positive terminal of voltage regulator to rheostat one end, this end, and rheostat second end to commutator one knob, the opposite knob, commutator opposite knob from there, and it is connected to positive terminal of ammeter and negative terminal of ammeter to voltage source. These are the connections. Experiment, how to do the experiment, we'll see. See here, plug key, it has four holes. You close any two opposite holes. So when you close two opposite holes, first you check the deflection in ammeter, read the value, and also check the deflection in deflection magnetometer. So deflection must be there. Again, change these pins in place in opposite direction, other opposite holes. Then also see the deflection. The magnitude of current reads should be same as initial, and here deflection should be seen in the deflection magnetometer. Then if you find these two things properly, now it is ready to do the experiment. Okay, now we'll see. So here you may have doubt, if you place one more key over here, what happens? One more key if you place, nothing happens, because current will circulate only in this coil. It will not pass through here because we are disconnecting here, right? So when you place in opposite directions only, see, once current passes like this, enters into in this direction, again entering into here, flows through the coil, again enters here, passes through it. So cycle is completed. There is no obstruction for current flow. So initially what we'll see is, let us make the current flow pass from this direction. To make it, let us place these two pins in these holes. Now current is passing through the rheostat and reaches to here, again passing through this wire, entering into the coil, passes, again leaving this direction, circuit will be completed. Now we'll see procedure, how to do the experiment, right? After placing these two pins in the commutator, note down how much reading is there in the ammeter. It is I is equal to 0.2 amps is there. So 0.2 amps current is flowing in the coil, right? And see the deflection. The deflection, you have to adjust rheostat such that the deflection is about 60 degrees in the deflection magnetometer. So, and this deflection magnetometer is there at the center of the coil. That means the X is the distance on the axis of the coil. Okay, here readings will be there. You can check X is 0. This mark should coincide X value 0 and 0, 10, 15, like that readings are there, right? This is X parameter. So initially X is equal to 0. At X is equal to 0, the deflection is 60. 60 is there. That also we can note down. See here in the table, at distance at X equal to 0, theta 1, theta 2. At this position, theta 1, theta 2 is 60 and 60, right? And theta 3, theta 4 is what? You have to change the knobs. That means you have to change the direction of the current in the coil. To change the direction of the current, remove knobs and keep in other opposite holes. Now after that, check out the readings at X equal to 0. See here, you have to wait till it comes to rest. And see that table or setup is not get disturbed. So this is around 55 we are getting. Okay, exactly you have to note down. Around 55, that is theta 3, theta 4. Because it is X equal to 0, we are not taking deflection east-west. It is X equal to 0 in the sense east side and west side. That is east arm, this one. This is east arm. Okay. Opposite arm is west arm. At X equal to 0, you note down the readings. Same readings. Post the readings, same readings in east and west directions. So at 0, this is 60, 60 and 55, 55. So these values will be same for x equal to 0. Now we will place the deflection magnetometer at 2, x equal to 2. Right? Before placing it, change the pins to the initial points, initial holes. Now we'll see where is x is equal to 2. On east side we'll place. This is 0, right? 0, this is 0, this is 1, this is 2. At x equal to 2, we have placed. At x equal to 2, note down the readings. See, the deflection around, it is without parallax error, we have to see around 59, 64, it's showing. Okay, 59, 64. Right. Now at the same distance, change the direction of the current by changing the keys. Now note down the reading. Again, how much it is there? It is reading almost 55, 56, or almost 55, 55. Actually, you can continue on east side all the distances, but just for demo purpose, I am taking west side also. Now you place this on west side at 2 centimeters. It is at 2 centimeters. Now place the pins how you placed initially. Wait till the aluminium pointer comes to rest. See the readings. Now readings almost here it is seen 60-60. Okay. Similarly, you note down there, change the pins, change the direction. After changing the direction, again note down the readings, write the at the west side. Okay, so in the same manner, you have to at different distances along the axis of the coil in east direction, at different distances along the axis of the coil along west direction. Take the readings. You can take 0 to 0 centimeter, its center, 2 centimeter, 4 centimeter, 6 centimeter, 8 centimeter, 10 centimeter. For every distance other than 0, you will get 8 readings, 4 readings on one arm, 4 readings on another arm. That is 4 deflections on one arm and 4 deflections on another arm. Okay.
Dear students, we'll see the this calculation part. If you see in table, there are 4 parts. Distance x, so this is the distance we place from the center of the coil to any side, either east or west. Okay, this is the x, right? So that distance from the center of the coil is x. So at any distance, if you at any distance if you place deflection magnetometer, that will be deflected, right, at a distance. This is the at somewhere at distance x, right? So the deflection magnetometer, when it is deflects on any arm, we get readings theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4. On this is east side, this is west side. Okay, so in west side also you will get readings. These are the theta 5, theta 6, theta 7, theta 8. Now we'll see what is theta 1, theta 2, theta 3. See commutator, if you see the commutator has 4 holes, Right, we choose any two pins at the two opposite ends, then current flows in one direction. Corresponding to that direction, I am giving positions 1, 2. Corresponding to that direction, the deflection that is there, that is shown in the deflection magnetometer, is theta 1, theta 2. This is the theta 1, theta 2 value when these pins are placed in those holes. Now we'll change the direction of the current. Now we'll place in 3 and 4 holes. At that situation, what happens? The deflection obviously reverses to the initial. Then the readings are theta 3, theta 4. Okay, so you are placing pins at first 1, 2 positions. Accordingly, theta 1, theta 2 we get. When you place at 3 and 4 positions, you will get theta 3, theta 4, right? Similarly, in west direction, that is when you place deflection magnetometer over here, that is in the next arm, second arm, for 1, 2 positions, when pin is placed in commutator, theta 5, theta 6, and 3, 4 position, it is theta 7, theta 8. These are the deflections. Okay, that is just changing the direction of current. In one particular direction, theta 1, theta 2. At the same distance, at the same arm, on the same arm, when you change the direction of the current, theta 3, theta 4. Similarly, if you change the arm, if deflection magnetometer is moved to the second arm here also, depending on the direction of current, theta 3, theta 4, and theta 5, theta 6 is obtained. Okay, so here the thing you have to remember is 1, 2, whatever the positions corresponding theta 1, theta 2, throughout the experiment at any distance you have to maintain same phenomena. At 1, 2, these positions are 1, 2, and these are 3, 4, that you maintain. Okay, that is very, very important. Now, let us take readings. I will give few experimental readings over here. See here, the first at 0 centimeter, that means what? At the center of the coil. At the center of the coil. Here, x equal to how much? 0. From there, we measure the x. Right? So, at x equal to 0, we got it 60, 60, 64, 64 in east direction. 60, 60 is what? When you place deflection magnetometer in east direction for 1 comma 2 positions in the commutator, that is current flows in one direction, say clockwise direction, then theta 1, theta 2 are the readings. At the same position, if you change the pins to 3, 4, here 3 and here 4, then current direction reverses. Then whatever the readings we get are theta 3, theta 4 at the same distance and on the same arm. So those are theta 1, theta 2, theta 3, theta 4. We got 60, 60, 64, 64. Take the mean of them and tan theta value of 62. Similarly, at 2 centimeters and the same arm. Like that, you can take 4 centimeters, 6 centimeters, 8 centimeters. Now change the arm. Actually, at 0, because it is at center, once you just disturb the position, again place the deflection magnetometer at center, then you may get the readings like this. But that is also not required, not to disturb. Same, whatever the readings here are there, you can write. So now coming to the 2 cm, if you place at 2 centimeters, that is say here now it is 2 centimeters distance on east. For in this direction of current, clockwise direction of current, 1, 2, theta 1, theta 2, note down it, and opposite direction, theta 3, theta 4, that is also note down. When you note down 60, 59, 60, 62, these are the readings we get, and this is mean and tan theta value. Now, move deflection magnetometer to second west arm. Actually, you can do you can take all the readings at the single arm, or you can take after taking 2 centimeter, you can go to the west, again coming to the east, take it 4 centimeter, go to the west, take it the 4 centimeters. Okay, that also you can do. So when you take readings on the west side, so here some deflections, again same, one, two positions of commutator clockwise, there theta 5, theta 6 readings, and 3, 4 positions of the commutator anti-clockwise direction, current flows in anti-clockwise direction, then theta 7, theta 8 readings you will get. Okay, so these are the readings we got here, and mean value of those west, finally tan theta w, and average of the tan theta, tan theta east plus tan theta west by 2, and according to tangent law, b equal to bh tan theta, right? So now another important thing is to using two formulae you have to measure the calculations. See here, this is according to Biot-Savart law, this is the formula. Okay, magnetic field due to coil on its axis, okay, magnetic field on the axis of a coil which is carrying I current. I is the current flow, we have set here 0.2 amps, N is the number of turnings, that is taken 50 for the demo purpose, and A is the radius of the coil, and X is the distance on the frame, okay, on west or east side. So in this formula, if you observe, everything is constant. Mu naught is constant, N is constant, I is constant, A is constant, only variable is X. So we are varying X, X equal to 0, 2 centimeter, 4, 6, 8, 10 centimeter, in that way you can take. And remember, take all in single unit, take better it is take in SI units. Now mu naught 4.2 to 10 power minus 7. You have to calculate B value, B experimental I wrote here, no, using this formula, Biot-Savart formula, and also you have to calculate using tangent formula. So for example, at 0 centimeters and 2 centimeters, you got B value using Biot-Savart law like this. How much? 5.6373 into 10 power minus 5. This is 5.5916 into 10 power minus 5 Tesla. So both the values are almost same. Similarly, at 2 centimeter you see. So you all the observations, 3 or 4 or 8, 6, whatever the distances you take, these values must be almost the same. Due to some experimental errors, little variation you will get. Okay. So that you remember and do in the examination well. This is the calculation. Finally, remember the result also. Finally, you have to write result. What is the result? The variation of magnetic field along the axis of the coil is measured, and also write the precautions. What are the precautions we used? In the case of precautions, you should not have any, let me take another paper. So in the case of precautions, no magnets, external magnets or magnetic materials must be nearer to the apparatus. Okay, that is very, very important. And that is one precaution you have to note down. Also, second one is check the connections. Third one important is calibrated initially by faculty members, we do it, but here I mean to say calibration is setting the system, setting the apparatus in a proper manner by checking its orientation using spirit level. That is, you have to check level, that's all, whether it is horizontal or not, otherwise the readings will not be same, deflections will not be same. Okay, so these are the things finally you have to get like this. Now after that you have to draw the graph. Take the graph like this at the center O, and along x-axis there is a distance axis. Okay, east direction values, west direction values, you take 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, similarly 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay, now when you take tan theta, while taking tan theta, see that range of the readings, minimum range to, okay, whatever the value is there, that you can take minimum to maximum, you first identify what is the minimum value, what is the maximum value. In our calculation, minimum value is how much? This is 0.6525. Maximum value is 1.88. So I can set the minimum value as 0, the maximum value as 2, and in between I can divide according to my wish, according to the graph. See, you have 0.8865 is the first reading. At least try to get 2 decimal points. After that, if you draw the graph, it will be like this. See in the graph. Okay.